from Las Vegas, it's theCUBE. Covering open systems, the future is crystal clear with security and SD-WAN. Brought to you by Open Systems.
Okay, welcome back. CUBE coverage here in Las Vegas. I'm John Furrier, the host of theCUBE. We are here at the Chandelier Bar at the Cosmopolitan Hotel, also known as Cosmo. We're here as part of Open Systems' exclusive expert, influencer, and customer party as part of the overall week going on. Gartner's big event going on. A lot of action. We're here, and our next guest is Moritz Mann, Chief Product Officer, CPO of Open Systems. Welcome to theCUBE.
Thanks for coming. Good evening.
So you're got the keys to the kingdom. The product chief product officer has to run all the products.
Yeah, of course.
You're in high demand from engineering to marketing.
And sales, of course.
Sales.
And the customers.
Where's the product? Sales blames product, product blames sales. You know, you got to have that relationship. If it's harmonious,
it'll work.
You guys are successful, so it's working.
Yeah, it is. And actually, I think the most important part are in the equation are the customers. So I see more the sales and especially customer success as kind of the gateway towards the customer to actually figure out where can we solve more problems for our customers and
so
create value.
Take a step back and explain the value proposition for your product. First, describe the product or products, the core products, and the main value proposition.
Yeah, so Open System was founded to actually solve the key issue of a modern enterprise, which is helping enterprises to actually master the digital transformation. And digital transformation is like one of those big words, and in action it means that you have enterprises adopting multi-cloud environments, connecting different locations cost efficiently, but also securing their key business process at that same time. So our solution comes in as a platform approach, and we'll solve these issues by connecting actually the end users, the business processes with the cloud and the applications and the customers.
So operations is a big part of your success.
So
operating, helping operators.
Exactly. So despite being like just another appliance vendor or product vendor or infrastructure vendor, we offer our service as a true service solution.
Service.
So it's a managed service.
Got it. Yeah.
That you subscribe as a service. So you consume as a service, you pay per user. You don't have to worry about hardware, appliance costs, and scaling of those costs and software.
SaaS, classic SaaS model.
Yeah, classic SaaS.
What problem are you solving for the customer? Where are you guys winning? Why are they using you guys? Why are they buying you?
Yeah, I think one of the keys is a turnkey solution that comes with the operational excellence included and managed operations part. And one of the key differentiators is that we have a next generation security stack in this SD-WAN platform. So we're not only providing and delivering applications for the end users and the customers, we are also protecting those applications from threats like ransomware attacks, threat actors inside the network and in the cloud environments.
And so explain the security stack piece that's built into the SD-WAN product.
Yeah.
And this glue software that you guys wrote?
Yeah, so we have an OEM, it's like a highly scalable platform that consists of open source components with OEM premium components that do DPI and application detection and security threat detection. And these security functions can be enabled by use case. So for instance, we have a piece that just is primarily there to detect any lateral movement to prevent another ransomware attack like Maersk got hit to.
So I'm going to ask you a question, I'll put you on the spot. So I'm a customer.
Yeah.
And sometimes I don't know I have a problem. I'm a frog in boiling water, whatever the metaphor is. And I got issues.
Yeah.
When do I know when to call you? What's happening around me as a customer to call up Open Systems to solve my problem? And what are some of the symptoms I might see? What's it look like? Is it security sprawl, all these solutions? Is it just not enough staff? I mean, what are some of the symptoms that make me want to dial you guys up?
Great question. So one of the symptoms is that you notice that your end users are complaining. So they have spotty internet, they have slow internet access, or you have SAP application owners, for instance, that are very unsatisfied about the application performance inside the WAN or to the cloud. And you will notice that that's when we got called, and we will help you to actually maximize your network so that you can actually focus on your core business and not about where do we have to scale the infrastructure.
So performance number one.
It's performance.
So basic performance stuff. What else?
It's all about also visualizing and telling where's actually, do the customers have a good, or end users have a good performance of the network? And where they do I have to actually spend and invest in the network and the cloud environment to actually improve customer performance?
Okay, so here's another one. So, hey, Moritz, I already got security covered.
Yeah.
Why do I need more secure WAN, SD-WAN? What gives?
Yeah, I mean, security, you can spend endless money in security and yet have another appliance, another product to patch like a tactile problem. But you will end up in a growing stack of complexity. We'll provide you with a very strategic solution that will help you to cover 80% of your problems, and in the end you have a budgetable solution that prevents the most severe threats to your network and to your applications.
Okay, cool. Thanks for sharing that insight. This is like the customer dynamic. Now I want to get to the innovation piece. So SD-WAN used to be a bunch of network guys managing QoS, mostly packet stuff, you know, MPLS routes, all that good stuff. We kind of knew all that's kind of like, but as the cloud comes in and as cloud operations and IT operations start to see things like automation, AI, machine learning, data and all this stuff plays a new role, they're rethinking their architecture. So what innovations are on the horizon that you see coming that will change the landscape of what SD-WAN is and what it will become? What are the innovation areas to watch?
Yeah, I mean, we are working already on the next generation for next year, which will enable our customers to identify any application inside the network independent of where that application is. So it will be crucial to not think anymore in networks and how many appliances do I have where, but how fast can I get an application up and running in a new cloud. And this is where we are investing a lot into cloud delivery, cloud integration, especially also with a partnership with Microsoft. We have an API integration to build and actually launch new applications directly from the cloud, but integrated into the SD-WAN, and including also all the security parameters that you need to secure in order to actually have not only application running and integrated in the network, which is called intent-based networking on the Gartner terms, but also have that secured in terms of business risk protection.
What's the biggest feature request that you get asked for? Because you're managing the product team, you're doing roadmaps, you're here planning, getting your marketing and sales teams, you're listening to customers. What are they asking for? What's your priorities?
So priorities foremost is automation and simplification. These are core aspects in order to keep up with the new complexity that arises also in the cloud sprawl that's happening. So customers are not launching one cloud, not two, but multiple clouds in parallel, which they ask for actually orchestration through the network and through integrated into their cloud orchestration. And secondly, it's the whole shadow IT. So where do I have SaaS applications I never knew about? How can we protect those applications as well and the data that we upload data to?
Security surface area is huge.
Yeah.
Final question for you. For people that are learning about who you guys are, open systems is expanding in the US. You're already successful. You got great revenue, great success on the product side, so congratulations. But for the people that are learning about you, what's the culture like, and what one thing should they know about open systems that they should know about?
Yeah, I think one cultural element that we really bring to the table is we are unconventional in the way that how we solve customer problems and the amount of dedication and passion we put into delivering the solution. So one of our core pillars is the DevOps model. So that means that the engineers that are building that platform are also at the same time your first tier context when it comes to service management and support. That it truly makes a difference in the customer experience.
Programmable internet, programmable software, programmable DevOps is about infrastructure as code.
Yeah.
So you guys are like SD-WAN as code.
Exactly. It's similar to that. Yeah.
It's a new trend. It's like blockchain.
Exactly.
Just add blockchain to anything, it's popular.
We try to be as simple as that, that's true.
Moritz, thanks for coming on theCUBE. Late night here. This is theCUBE After Dark. We are here at the Chandelier Lounge at the Cosmopolitan Hotel for CUBE coverage of Open Systems event for influencers, executives, experts, and customers, and of course, influencers of theCUBE. We'll be back with more after this short break.